Duke Grant Sports Network is back for 2018, and before we go forward, we gotta go back. Looking at the top 20 teams pound for pound in the state of Maryland from 2017. This post is sponsored by iDetail Maryland, the top auto retailer in the state of Maryland. Just give them a call, they will come to you. Call 410-635-0471. You will not be disappointed. iDetail Maryland. And now, number 20, the 11U WHC Warhawks of the Mid-Maryland Youth Football and Cheer League. Speed and precision was their game. Good passing game, good running game, good kicking game. Here you see on special teams it looked like a bobble, but you see number 5 making nifty moves to get the extra point. This was the kind of team that you didn't want to mess with because their defense was stout as well as their offense. They came from the Mid-Mountain Youth Football Conference and they were a team to be reckoned with, a champion in that league only to fall short in the state. But here you see that kind of speed that they showed, that precision, good play calling, great coaching, just a very good football team. And they land as number 20, pound for pound. You see number 5, that speed. This is something that happened all year long. What a great and powerful team they were. Number 19, the 14U Lock Raven Ravens of the Maryland Youth Football Alliance. One of the real tough teams, one of the speedy teams. As we watch some of the most talented, look at this, as you see this runner. He was running so fast that the camera couldn't even focus on. Look at him just blazing down the sideline. This was the kind of talent on display whenever you saw this Lock Raven team get down. This 14U team was potent, as you see at wide receiver, on offense and on defense, as you see that defensive line close in on the quarterback. This was one of those teams that you just knew that when you played this team, you had to deal with power and speed, as you see number 9 just splash his way into the end zone. This was just one of those teams that you had to like. You loved to watch them. They had all kinds of talent. You can see shimmying from the wide receiver, from the tight end, from the running backs, the cornerbacks, the offensive and defensive line. Just a great team, well coached, and play call that was beautiful. And you saw the kind of speed that makes you want to just watch youth football. Everywhere you look, there was talent. Here, as you see the running back blaze his way into the end zone. This was that kind of team in that kind of very tough league. This was the kind of team and the kind of plays that you wanted to see. Number 18, the 12U TSA Green Hawks, also of the Maryland Youth Football Alliance. There you see one of their workhorses, number 32. He had this sit down style, but once he got the ball, he was gone. Here, you see again, he gets the ball in the on the inside and then cuts straight up the field using speed that is really foreign to most youth football teams. You watch him and you just marvel. Remind me of Marcus Allen or O.J. Simpson as a young man. He just blazes his way into the end zone. He can smell that touchdown. Watch here, on defense, you see pick off a pass and dash down the sideline using that speed and that agility to go into the end zone. Watch this here again. Quarterback goes up, number 32 right there to get the ball. As you see, he just has his eyes on the prize. and he's able to dash into the end zone. It wasn't a one-man show, though. Here you see another, this time number 85 getting the interception. This was just one of those teams that just didn't let you rest, whether you were on offense or defense. But when you were on offense and they gave it to number 32, oh my God, if you let him hit that corner, forget it. He is gone.
Number 18, TSA Greenhawks. And number 17, coming in at 17, the 11U Bel Air Terps of the UCYFL. These are the homeboys of the Duke, baby. They had great grit. This is one of those teams that just use strength, power, and precision. Great play calling and just great grit. They went straight power. They never disguised what they were going to do. They let you know right up top, this is what we're doing. We're going for power. We're going to rush your quarterback. We're going to run the football straight up the gut. And we're going to do what we do, baby. And we're going to tell you what we're going to do. And it's up to you to try to stop us. They went through the UCYFL and went all the way to the finals of the state championship, only to fall short. But this was one great team in the tradition of Bel Air Terp football. Just being tough, having great offensive and defensive lines, and trying to control the line of scrimmage. Here you see that tough running game right at the goal line. As you see, they just powered their way in for a winning touchdown. This is the Terp. This is Terp football. You can check them. We've been watching them for years. They do the same thing. They got talent. They got speed. But they got grit. That's what makes them the Bel Air Terps. Number 17 of the UCYFL, pound for pound, state of Maryland. Number 16, the 10U Edgewood Tigers, also of the UCYFL. Speed, agility, jitterbugging. Look at number 2. But he likes to make it look good. He likes to make it look jiggy. Look at him going up and down the field. This is how they make it go. Always speed on the outside and a lot of precision and a lot of jitterbugging on the inside, making you miss, breaking ankles all the way. Look at number 2. Woo-hoo! He has got some talent. Let me tell you, when you come to Tigerland, you know it's going to be something special. Watch that defense. They just come at you. They come at you from all kinds of ways. Their coaches always think outside the box. Here you see the running back getting into the end zone. A lot of jitterbugging, but also a lot of just sheer talent and speed. Here you see number 10 as he gets himself into the end zone. This is what they do. On offense and on defense, they just strut. They like to just go at you. This is a team that was in contention all the way for the 10U crown in the UCYFL, only to fall short to the same Bel Air Terp team that you're watching right now. They played really tough, close games that could have gone either way. But this was definitely one of the top teams in the state of Maryland. Watch this kickoff, and this is just indicative of what you will see. As you see number 2, he is just dancing, looking like Deion Sanders, having that little shiftiness, the speed. He just makes you miss. And then when he gets in the open, it's all she wrote as he dances into the end zone for a touchdown. And that's all, folks. Keep it locked right here as we continue our top 20 countdown. We are Duke Grand Sports Network, the time capsule of youth sports moments, and the home of the baddest young dudes in sports.